Thank you. First of all, I feel a little bit nervous because my first talk on this for International Plenary in English. What I present today is a part of a research project we done with several stakeholders from municipalities and another universities in our region of Cologne in Germany. Cologne, if you can't for his cathedral and the carnival. In the region out Cologne, we have an influx from 107,000 people, 170,000 people from 2080 to 2040. Past Corona, the news information said to 2050. These people came from new industries like IT and bioscience and aviation, and for these people we need like 3,300 hectares of new settlement areas. And this is a big problem because we have conflicts with agriculture and natural resources. And on the other part, we have in the region a structural change in the traditional industries like light mining for light coal and chemistry industry. Now, so we have the typical situation of urban sprawl at the moment, and we would look in our project how can we bring this development of more sustainable with ongoing the SDG number 11 and the SDG number 2 in secondary. For this, we have three main questions on my work. It's possible to develop land use model on open source software and open data, and what can the model bring for the stakeholders in the region and for the urban planning. For check it's possible to develop a model, we have developed two scenarios with the local stakeholders for the development of the region from 2018 to 2015. One scenario is we ongo with the current development of new residential areas. And the other scenario is we will protect very high potential areas too from development of new residential areas. And we have looked for some predictors who were interesting for people you go in new residential areas. The predictors can you see in Zoom? That the distance to train stations, motorways, and social infrastructure. On these days, we have look if we can find open data through this themes. For the current land use, the government of Germany and North Rhine-Westphalia have all data over land use bring on a free license, which near is to a non-zero license. That we have free information over current land use. Then the public transport organizations bring her information to the CC license. And the other information over social infrastructure and motorways we can find in OpenStreetMap. So we have free data. But the devil is in the detail. First of all, for a good model, we must bring this data of a uniform grid from 100 and 400 and 100 meter per grid cell. And one problem is the mostly data have topological and geometric errors. So, we have the data, now we must look for a model. You can see the results of the data for processing. That is the current land use in the region based on the German official catastrophe system. That's the distance to the train station and to the motorway.
Please speak to the microphone. Otherwise.
Okay. 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 Now and we have looked what for software we have for model, and we have lot of good open source tools for such land use model. We have found a way to build up model in completely open source stack with QGIS. PostGIS, Postgres as database, and the typical Python scientific stack with pandas and scikit-learn and NumPy. To simulate the allocation process of the residential areas, we use a random forest model. But first, before we can use the model, we must pre-process the data in SQL. First, we must the data bring of one similar projection. Then we must repair the broken geometries and topologies. Then we can cut the data to the study area, and in the last strip, we transform the data of the uniform grid. With this data, we can train the random forest with the current land use and the describing factors. Now, if we train the random forest, we gave the random forest the information from the different scenarios, either the current practice or the maintaining agriculture scenario, who we protect the very high agriculture areas. After the random forest process, we became a map of potential new residential area grid cells. With this map, we go in the second step of the model, who we distributed the needed new residential spaces on the potential areas, and we evaluate the model results with some tools. Now, the evaluation of the results, we have developed 20 indicators from 5 categories are used for evaluation to universal, and they offer sustainability, and we can analyze the impact of the new residential areas to on protected species, on protected plants, to show conflicts for the regional planning and the urban planning very early. On this slide, you can see some indicators. We have indicators from social infrastructure, for the agriculture value of areas, and for ecological questions. Now we see the first result. The first result is the map of the potential new areas. You can see in here.
Maybe you can use this.
Yes.
There is a pointer.
For me, it's difficult. I'm visually impaired.
Yes, sorry.
Okay.
It should be like that.
Okay, thank you. We can see here. We can see the which shell from agriculture is changed to potential new area in which scenario. in the second map, she is I write that not good to see. We can see which question in which year will be changed from agriculture to residential area. And the stakeholders say main result is they have a chance to found conflicts very early with nature conservation or other things. That is a problem in the German regional planning system, because information over conflicts came in the planning in German planning systems very late, and so it's the mostly planning was going on, and the justice must look what to do with conflicts with nature or with agriculture. Now we have a tool, we can see the conflicts very, very, very early and can give some other sustainable development chances. At the moment, I will re-implement the model with some new technologies. Since I have the model developed in the year 2018, we have some nice new software libraries, like GeoPandas, like Fiona, like Moving Pandas, and the Open Root Service from Heidelberg, so that we have a such better model in the next year. What will I implement it as a QGIS plugin, so that people can use the model all over the world, because I have checked that the model works with the current land use data and with distance data from other countries. On my journey to Norway last year, I have tested the model with Norwegian data, and it works seamless too. Right. As it works seamless too. And if some people have regions or can test the model in the world, I'm very interested. Questions and discussing points?
So, thank you, Mirko, for your presentation.